I'm Jillian.
And I'm Morgan. Welcome back to Neshoba News.
Morgan, how are you doing as we make our way toward winter break?
I'm all right. My caffeine addiction has definitely helped get me through.
Well, we're almost there. We've just got to push through.
Now let's head over to Ethan and Millen with Question of the Week.
Hi, I'm Ethan.
And I'm Millen.
And the question of the week is, what is your favorite Christmas movie?
Let's go.
And I'm here with...
Anthony.
Nasor.
And the question of the week is, what is your favorite Christmas movie?
I'd have to say the Griswold Christmas Vacation.
Probably Just Friends.
Good choices, good choices. I'm here with...
Adam McLaughlin.
And the question of the week is, what is your favorite Christmas movie?
I'd have to say Home Alone.
The classic movie.
Indeed.
I'm here with Jack London. We're going to ask him what his favorite Christmas movie is. Jack, what's your favorite Christmas movie?
You know, I got to go with Elf.
That's an interesting pick. I'm here with...
Kirlin.
And the question is, what is your favorite Christmas movie?
Home Alone. Home Alone 1.
That's a good one.
And we're here with...
Max.
And the question of the week is, what is your favorite Christmas movie?
Probably Home Alone 2.
Oh, that's a classic. And we're here with...
Megan Horahan.
Addie Bandini. Emerson Souza.
And the question of the week is, what's your favorite Christmas movie?
I'd have to go with Elf.
I think me too.
Yeah, same.
We're here with...
Kenzie.
And the question of the week is, what's your favorite Christmas movie?
Arthur Christmas.
I've never seen that one.
It's so good. It's on Max.
It's on Max? Mm-hmm. I gotta watch it.
It's good.
I'm here with...
Megan.
And the question of the week is, what is your favorite Christmas movie?
Elf.
Terrible choice. I'm here with...
Mrs. Hilliger.
And the question of the week is, what is your favorite Christmas movie?
A Christmas Story. Every year, every Christmas.
That's a good one. I just watched it over Thanksgiving break.
Great one. Mm-hmm. Let's go.
Thank you. I'm here with...
Nate Machado.
Ryan Sweeney.
And the question is, what is your favorite Christmas movie?
I'm going to have to go with the Polar Express.
I'm going to go with Home Alone.
I like both of those. Thank you.
Yeah, of course.
And we're here with...
Irvin Carnes.
And Gavin.
And the question of the week is, what is your favorite Christmas movie?
Gotta go with the classic Elf on this one.
That's a stone cold classic. I'd have to go with Home Alone.
I have to disagree with Elf, but really? Home Alone, right. That's a quality choice right there. Yeah. And we're here with...
Joey.
Calories.
Chad.
And the question of the week is, what is your favorite Christmas movie?
Probably Elf. I'm gonna go with Christmas Vacation.
Yeah. I'm also gonna go with Christmas Vacation.
There you go. Mm-hmm.
Christmas Vacation is solid. Elf. Ugh.
Man.
Are you for real?
Yeah.
That's a hot take.
Alright, man.
I'm here with...
Millen.
What's your favorite Christmas movie?
I have to say Home Alone 2.
It's a good answer.
Yeah.
Okay, W pick, Millen.
W pick. So today I'm here with...
Mason Holmes.
And Larissa's boyfriend.
Luke.
And the question of the day is, what's your favorite Christmas movie?
Project X.
Elf.
Home Alone for sure.
Are you going to watch Elf with Larissa this Christmas?
Yes, your question.
Yes.
Yes.
You heard it here first, guys.
I'm here with Ms. Dontrema, and the question is, what is your favorite Christmas movie?
Elf. 100% Elf.
Completely disagree. I'm here with Ms. Landry, and the question is, what is your favorite Christmas movie?
It's a Wonderful Life.
That's a good one.
Yeah. I used to go see it at, like, every year it would be at the Strand, when the Strand was open in Clinton, and I used to go see it.
It's a nice choice. Yes. Thank you. I'm here with...
Haley.
And the question is, what is your favorite Christmas movie?
I like Rudolph.
That's a good one. I like that one too. Thank you. I'm here with Jacob Horan, and the question is, what is your favorite Christmas movie?
A Year Without a Santa Claus.
I haven't heard of that one. I'm also here with Liam Gulliver.
Charlie Brown's Christmas.
Nice, very nice.
And we're here with...
Paxton Kwong.
John. And the question of the week is, what is your favorite Christmas movie?
I'm going to have to go with Grinch. It's a Wonderful Life.
Some solid choices right there. That's it for question of the week. Now back to Morgan and Jillian.
Those are some great choices. Jillian, what's your favorite Christmas movie?
I'll have to say Charlie Brown's Christmas. It's very nostalgic and I love the soundtrack. How about you?
I'll choose Die Hard. It's definitely a classic.
For sure.
Neshoba Ski and Snowboarding Club at Wachusett Mountain has 6 discounted sessions in January and February. If you go to wachusett.com and find the school group section, Neshoba's code is NRSCH. Sign up and hit the slopes.
Now over to the regional report.
Hi, I'm here with
Miss Norton.
And can you explain to us what the DECA Mock Competition is?
Sure. So for our mock competition, we have all of our business students along with all of our DECA members come on down and just try out what it's like to be at a DECA competition.
Perfect. Thank you. Okay, so we are here at the DECA Mock, and I'm with
Paul Sabrin.
So are you excited?
Yeah, I'm super excited for this. This is probably going to be one of the best days of Neshoba history.
What's your category?
I am CS. I'm doing it with my partner, Bovley, and we're going to take it home this year.
Fantastic. Okay, so now we're doing a little sneak peek into all the presentations.
DECA is really good real-world experience.
I love DECA because I get to share ideas and meet new people.
I also really want to go to California,
and I love the pizza.
Okay, so what I really enjoy about DECA is the partner aspect and just working in groups, and I also really like how it brings fun experiences to look back on.
And DECA offers very beneficial experience in business practices such as problem solving, public speaking.
DECA members will compete at the district level in January, and those that qualify will move on to states, which will take place in Boston in March. We'll keep you updated on their journey.
Also, Stuka will be selling candy grams at lunch today through the 20th.
A single candy cane is $1 and a bag of candy is $3.
Stuka members will deliver the candy on 12/21.
Make sure you know your friend's English teacher because you'll need to put it on the tag.
Now over to Eve and Vlad with the campus update.
Thanks, Morgan. We have some exciting new developments for the new school.
We are currently in the design development stage, which means that plans are getting more and more refined and the budget is becoming more concrete.
Construction will begin this spring. Due to the construction, parking in the student parking lot will be compromised. However, there will be a new temporary student lot that will prioritize parking for seniors.
Starting today, room 206 will turn into a model classroom for students to try out furniture and new room designs. The furniture will be coming from 3 different companies, and there will be a Google form available to provide your opinion on the furniture.
There will be some new rooms created in the building as well, including dressing rooms, a black box theater / broadcast studio, and more in a more professional food lab.
If construction goes according to schedule, the building will be open for the 2027-2028 school year. This means that this year's 8th graders will get to use the building as seniors.
Now on to car critiquers.
Welcome back to Car Critiquers.
We've got some good stuff for you today. Vroom vroom! Our next duo of victims is these two wonderful cars. May or may not know who these belong to. Not 100% sure though, so we're not even going to talk about it. But in turn, we'll start with this one. I believe it's a BMW. It's black, I believe. I am colorblind. Don't quote me on that. But it has some nice leather upholstery in seats, I will be honest. The parking job on this one, it's a little skewed, if we're being honest. It's way too far to this side. Needs to be more to this side. But I can't drive. So this car, also in the back, has room. It has a decent amount of room. I would say maybe like a foot and a half is my guess. Now, I like the overall look of the car. No decorations, I will be honest. Bella, get to work on that. Put some decorations on here. But
The inside looks very clean. The outside of the car, not too shabby. It's all right. I'm gonna give this car on itself a 7 out of 10. Moving on to our next victim. This would be, I believe, Mr. Roth. One of the 7, because there's about 15 of them. But he has a white, I think that's a Lexus. Do not quote me on that. Don't know cars. Don't know why they put the gay person on this segment, but the inside of the car, it's nice. It's tan, has some leather. I don't hate it. The parking job, I will say though, way too over here. He's on the line, so that's a point deduction right there. He's trying to get way too close to Bella. Leave room for God. This side, there is a lot of space. This is where he put the room for God. He should have put it in between them instead. Curtis, be better. Better, be better. On the back, we have some room. I would say maybe about a foot, I'm guessing. Looks like a foot to me. The car's cleanliness, 6 out of 10. You can clean it, Kurt. I know you can. The overall decorations, there are none. Kurt, do better. 3 out of 10. Parking job, 4 out of 10. That's overall probably like what? Like a 5 out of 10? That's my solid guess. Overall, Bella, you're doing way better off than him in terms of parking.
All right, the next car we have is this one here. And as you can see, their parking job is also not the greatest. They're clearly very up on the curb. And also not that straight in the spot. If we come around to the side, they're also very close to the line and definitely not the best at parking their car. Looking at how well the car is decorated, there's also nothing really that fun about this car. There's some leaves, you know, on the back, which, you know, super cute. And there's nothing on the windows, nothing on the front. They don't even have anything hanging from their mirror other than their parking pass. So this car probably gets like a 2 out of 10, maybe even a 1. Now we'll throw it back to Jill
and Morgan.
Those were some real creative parking jobs. I definitely agree. This Wednesday, December 13th, Neshoba Music will gather for a combined instrumental and vocal winter concert at the high school auditorium, beginning at 7 p.m. They will sing a medley of traditional holiday carols, so come on down and get yourself in the holiday spirit with us.
Sounds like a blast. Since we're unavailable for Neshoba Eats this week, we've decided to pass the torch to Harry.
Merry Glumpmas, and welcome to a new edition of Harry Eats. Today, we at Solomon Pond Mall to get some good munchin'.
Yes.
Now, if there's one thing I like about Ruby Thai, it's their portions. They give me a big meal.
There's a party in my belly.
Nate got the wonton soup, and he was over the roof.
Wa chao ni ma.
My favorite part is the chicken.
Though I loved the meal, I felt my mind wander. I needed a photo with Santa Claus.
Santa.
Guys, I'll never forget this incredible meal.
And with that, we set off home. With this incredible memory, forever in our hearts.
It's Santa Claus!
I wrote down what I wanted, and then my dreams came true!
Wonderful time of the year.
Welcome to Neshoba to Current Events, where we'll be covering major stories from across the U.S. I'm your host, Sam Millen, and we'll be covering the current lawsuit between X, formerly known as Twitter, and Elon Musk, and the liberal advocacy group Media Matters for fabricating pictures of major companies' ads appearing next to posts of pro-Nazi content. The result of the pictures led IBM, NBC Universal, and its parent company, Comcast, to remove their ads from X. San Francisco-based X says in its complaint filed with federal court in Fort Worth, Texas, that Media Matters knowingly and maliciously portrayed ads next to hateful material, as if they were what typical X users experience on the platform.
Musk was recently asked about the large advertisers boycotting putting ads on X in an interview at the DealBook Summit in New York this week. His response to the question was more questioning, followed by expletives. Then he turned to the crowd and waved, saying, "Hi, Bob." This was towards Bob Iger, who is present in the crowd and who is the CEO of Disney, one of the companies leading the advertising boycott. Texas Attorney General Glenn Paxton announced his office is launching an investigation into media matters for possible fraudulent activities in the group's report. That does it all for current events this week. Now back to Jillian and Morgan.
The week before we go on break, we're going to have our annual Winter Spirit Week.
Monday, December 18th, will be Holiday PJ Day.
Tuesday, December 19th, will be Ski Day.
Wednesday, December 20th, will be Ugly Sweater Day.
Oh, that's my favorite. Thursday, December 21st, will be Winter Wonderland Whiteout.
And Friday, December 22nd, will be Holiday Day. This means any type of holiday accessories like hats, socks, necklaces, etc.
Thanks for watching the Shoba News. Tune in again next week and stay warm out there.